in the land of the Grails. Yes, we are. Welcome back, folks. You read the description saying, don't buy a smokeless fire pit until you watch this. Because a lot of you out there that are buying smokeless fire pits, you also want to do some grilling. It would be nice, you know, Saturday night, fire up the smokeless fire pit, throw a couple steaks on, or maybe you want to do some smash burgers, or maybe even a pizza. Now, that would be cool. Now, folks, the good folks at Brio have listened to their customers. They've listened to you and said, you know what? Let's build a smokeless fire pit for those that want to do some grilling on it too. And that's what we've got here today. We're going to showcase today, just for you, the Live Fire Grill by Brio. I'm going to show you all the options. I'm going to show you how it works, folks. I'll show you the price. Yeah, we'll get to all that. I'm going to leave the link down below in the description so you can go online, purchase it right through there. Tell you what, let's get started. All right, so I will leave the original review I did on the Brio Live Fire down below in the description, along with the link, and it's an affiliate link. So, you know, if you're going to take a look, please use that link. That way the Brio folks know that you are looking at this grill or their products through Tom Horseman YouTube. And while you're there, don't forget to subscribe. Simple to do. This thing, I'll tell you what, I've used it once now, and it has got me very, very impressed. Let's dive into the base unit and how it all works. All right, so here's the base unit. This is how it comes in, and you have the assembly part, but everything was easy peasy. Probably about 30 to 40 minutes by myself. If you had help, probably even less. But it's got two side shelves. Remember, a lot of people, you know, said, hey, first of all, if I'm gonna be grilling on my smokeless fire pit, I don't wanna be way down there. I wanna be kinda up here. And we're gonna take a look at dimensions so you know what the heights really are. And you know, if you're gonna be grilling, you're gonna want some side tables. But you don't want them to be up all the time, so they make them so they're foldable. You can see that one folds down just like that one. And they're good heights, folks. And then you've got two storage shelves on there. So if you did wanna put some wood storage or some charcoal storage, because with this thing, you can use charcoal or you can use real wood. Works very nice. You got the bottle opener there, and you're wondering, Tom, wheels? So Tom Horseman on YouTube couldn't help himself. So this comes with like little nylon casters on it, and I decided to put wheels on it because here in the land of grills, things need to be a little bit on the more mobile side. So probably not so much for you, but more so for me. I tell you what, let's go online and take a look at the dimensions. All right, everybody always wants to know dimensions, and the best way is just to go to their website. So Live Fire Grill, like I said, if you use that link down below, it'll take you straight there. Go to specifications, and you can see our height total is 33, let's just call it 34 inches, and then back to front is 27, and with the tables out, we have 57 inches. So if you're putting this on your patio, and you know, you can see no wheels, I added the wheels because, in my opinion, a lot of times, maybe you're on the patio, but maybe on a Saturday night or a Friday night or something like this, you want to wheel it out to the driveway and have the neighbors over and do something. Having wheels on there, in my opinion, would be a great idea. Now, they do, there's more of the dimensions right there. I just want to look at the weight. So the weight is 125 pounds, and this is a stainless steel product, except for them shelves. The shelves are just powder coated steel. So a lot of cool things going on there. Let's get everything kind of back in there and show you more of the details. All right, so how does one of these work? So this is the very bottom of it. And a lot of people never know this, but as you can see, you've got a bunch of air holes there and you've got the ability to open them and close them. That's what lets the air in. The more air you have in there, the cleaner your fire is gonna be. The cleaner your fire is, the less smoke you're gonna have. That little tab there is how you control that. So you can see close, open. And that lets the air flow through. When you're done cooking, you close it. It's not gonna snuff off the grill. Now, they do sell an optional stainless steel cover you can put over that, but I bet you would snuff it out pretty good. All right, so now here's another key part of it. And this is, you can call this your charcoal tray or your wood tray. So that sits in there like this, and then you can put your charcoal in there, and I've cooked already with just lump charcoal in here, and it worked very, very well. And then if you want to put a split or two of wood in there, oh man, I'll tell you what, works very, very nice. And because you're not as deep as a traditional smokeless fire pit, you get to see more of the fire. And the nice thing about it is you got the handle here, so when things are cooled down, you can take this little thing out and just empty it out. In fact, if you have a garden, the ash, you know, from the wood ash is actually very good fertilizer. All right, so when you buy the basic version, and this is the basic version, what you're seeing right here, it comes with a skillet rest, and you can take and put a cast iron skillet right there, and you can cast iron sear some things on there. I've thought about, I like to do popcorn, and an aluminum pot that I set on there that's got a top on there, and you can do popcorn around the campfire. That's pretty cool. So let's take a look. I know everybody's saying, tell us the price. Let's take a look at the price. All right, this unit, as it sits right here, is $850. So if it was me, I would go for a bundle deal. And one of the bundles they have just takes it up to $900. And that's to get that stainless steel grill right there. Let's take a closer look at that, because that's really cool. All right, the Outpost grill. And I just want to give you the specifications. And this does give you the opportunity. It gives you, and I'll show you, this little stake here that if you're going camping, you can use this over a wood fire out in the real outdoors. But it is 100% stainless steel. Even the stainless steel post. Yeah, the post is stainless steel too. And that old thing, I believe, is, where does it say it? I believe it's USA made, but it is really cool. Let's just take a closer look. So here's, you know, if you were to go camping or something like that, that's all stainless steel. That is really very, very nice. And the construction of this thing is, it is actually almost too nice to use. Very sturdy. I want to show you how it goes in and out of the grill and how it locks in. I thought that was just
brilliant. All right, so the raise and lower, we'll talk about that first. You just loosen this up and you can raise and or lower it off.
And then to remove it, and this is the part that I thought was cool, is that I've got this right here. This lifts up, but then you've got a pin that's underneath that locks in. And you'll see that that becomes, I don't know if you can see that here, right down in there is where it is. And then once that's exposed, you can just pull it out, and then to lock it back in place, where'd that pin go? Here, you can see the pins right there. And they just go into the slots like that. And then you turn it, and then that locks it right into place. And then you just turn this and you're over the fire. That way you don't have to worry about this whole thing coming out when you're grilling. It's a great design by the Brio folks. Except you can click down below on the link and you see all the other bundles. The pizza one is very interesting. And then they have one that kind of has a cast iron pot and the cover, and it has the Outpost grill that we just saw. And it's got that thing right there. We'll talk about that next. This comes in a bundle. And once again, you know, if you're going to get this, you might as well bundle it, because right now you can get it with the griddle. Imagine doing smash burgers on something like that. $850. Let's take a closer look at this very heavy duty griddle. All right, so there's a flat top griddle. That is carbon steel. And I wanted to see what the weight was. And quarter inch. Who else has got a quarter inch carbon steel griddle? Oh, that is cool. And the weight is, yeah, you would expect 26 pounds. It is 24 inches. Just use the tape measure. We'll go with the narrowest part down here. It's 22 and a half there, and up here it's 24, and then your depth is, let's just say an average of about 10 inches. You got a cool zone up here. Your fire would be underneath there, so that's good. If I were to use this, and I am going to use this, your grease goes out there, so I'd have my fire, my charcoal underneath, and then I would just put a aluminum catch tray right there, just to catch the grease so I don't have a big mess to clean up. So I usually don't get very excited over grilling tools, because people are always sending them with their grill and say, hey, check out our custom line. But holy cow, these things, that's a spatula. I'll tell you what, it's all 304 stainless steel. And I don't know what the length of that thing is. Let's see, the fork, which I've got right here, is 21 inches. And the spatula is, that's 2 feet. 2 feet, in fact, a little bit further. You know, you can have a blazing fire and you're not gonna feel hardly anything with that. And then the tongs are also a little over 24 inches. Look at that. Now that's a tong right there. That's something I'm not getting rid of, folks. So I really like that a lot. I was impressed when I saw it. And it doesn't, it does take a little bit to impress me, but I've been impressed with this whole thing since the first day I got it. From delivery to assembly to, using it for the first time, I can't wait. I've got some bacon that I'm going to put on this. I'm just going to put some lump underneath there and season up that carbon steel.
with some thick cut bacon. We'll do a video of that. Tom Horseman, YouTube. Keep on watching. We'll show you more on the Brio as time goes on. Check out the link down below. Don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching, folks.